Gold Foil Funk. Link below in the description.
Am I still that one girl?
Yes, we've been deciding to waifu her up, so.
Whoa, what's going on here? I apprehensively placed my chocolate in her mouth.
Dude, missed it.
That sounds so hot.
Bro,
if you really think about that, that's really hot, too.
Dude, we were making waves last night.
That's awesome, man. Is that the girl I used to voice?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
You can still voice her.
But catch me up on the series. Are we still pursuing her? Is that what
we are? We are, yeah. We're trying to waifu her up.
Oh my god, I'm
and
honored.
It's fucking
it's working.
Working.
Yeah. She reads books with us. A perfect date. A perfect...
Wow, I love books.
And look, just this pose. Look at this beauty.
I know, dude. Yeah, I'm so happy we put that chocolate in her mouth.
Yeah, that's a really weird looking chocolate, though. This must be some kind of weird chocolate.
All sensuality aside, that is an absolutely beautiful art picture.
It really is.
It's so nice.
Look at her art. Her eyes are shimmering, dude.
I would put that as my desktop background if I actually thought Yuri was legitimate waifu material.
Speaking Wait, up, are I you telling a... me you don't think that?
Nah.
I need a new desktop background.
Yeah, mine's legit. Mine's been the Windows 1 default for years. No joke.
Bruh, that's why you guys gotta watch more anime to find waifus to just make your desktop background.
Alright, I got a picture of Lisa Ann full spread. Okay, I'm good.
I apprehensively placed the dick in her mouth.
It's just chocolate, you fuck.
Just like that, Yuri closes her lips over it.
No, 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 no.
Dude, we're just getting right into it.
Sweetie. You want to read Yuri or you want to read someone else's up to
I'll be Yuri again, dude.
Okay.
Dot.
Look at her eyes.
Yuri's expression suddenly breaks. Oh, no.
Did I just...
Yuri looks at me like she needs to confirm what just happened.
The cock's long.
Sorry.
It's so long.
I guess I shouldn't have done that.
Oh, sorry, that's you.
My line.
Sorry, I thought she was still talking, man.
Oh, that's... Well... You were just helping...
That's something that friends do.
No.
We just get friend zoned.
Right?
I mean, not really in this kind of context, but yeah.
Look at
that's
this
all it
sweat
was.
Drop. This sweat drop right here.
Yeah, that's what it is. Sweat.
Yeah.
That's the chocolate jizz. So.
I knew it.
Yeah.
Chocolate couldn't fucking trick me.
Then you don't need to stop or anything.
Oh! I see.
He says after going, oh!
I see.
The situation has gotten really tense. Yuri tries to return to the book.
Pussy.
But I can tell just by the puddle underneath her skirt that she can't even focus now.
Jesus.
My heart is pounding.
My dick is pounding.
I nervously take another chocolate between my fingers. This time Yuri's eyes meet mine. Oh, jeez.
Oh.
The ellipsis.
Oh.
How did it even come to this? Yuri doesn't avert her gaze. Bruh.
Great word.
Yeah, I noticed her chest rising and falling to the rhythm of her breasts. Yeah, like you weren't noticing that before.
I mean, she is wearing a school uniform, so...
I raise my arm.
Smack her across the...
Like before, Yuri parts her lips. Oh, this is getting spicy, but it's different this time.
Yeah.
I take the chocolate and place it in her mouth.
I can't wait to
this, read. This is the stuff that you read in a party or in a Discord call with three dudes. I feel her hot breath on my fingers. This is the
okay,
good
everyone.
Ah, oh, what the fuck, man!
Look, that's good enough.
What?
Uh-huh.
God damn it! Yuri jolts back.
It's time to share poems.
Oh, fuck off!
My cock song. You can help Yuri put away the tea stuff, right?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, thanks,
bitch.
Nipa.
The spell is abruptly broken. Come on, man.
That sucks, dude. We were on a roll. Oh.
Her eyes just disappear whenever she's
right. Like I'll take care of the cups.
I see you, P.
Yeah. Yuri picks up the teacups from the floor. And she grabs my tea bag. I pick up the bag of chocolates.
Alright, shut up. Very inappropriate. This is crossing the line.
In the end, we hastily clean up without so much as a word between us. I get the feeling this is something neither of us will have the courage to bring up. What?
Alright, who do we want to share the poem to first? Yuri, right?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, sure.
Let's see what you've written for today. Dot, dot, dot. Dot, 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 dot.
Yuri stares at the poem with a surprised expression on her face. Do you like it?
We don't get to hear our own poems. Bullshit, dude.
Dabs.
Dabs. My cock's long.
It's really long.
This one might even be better than yesterday's. How did you even pick up on this so quickly?
Almost like I was trying to get laid.
Just yesterday, I was telling you the kind of techniques worth practicing.
Maybe that's why. You did a good job explaining. I really wanted to try giving it more imagery.
Visibly swallows. What?
Bruh. Even her hands appear sweaty.
Knees weak, arms are spaghetti.
I'm not used to this.
Used to what?
I don't know.
Oh, well. It's fine. Take your time. Yuri breathes and collects her thoughts.
Collect.
I know that Yuri looks at it before she speaks, so I offer that patience to her.
Yeah. Just being approached like this, I guess.
And appreciated.
Appreciated.
Yeah, I'm gonna go back to college.
Probably sounds really stupid.
I know, he said approach instead of reason.
But seeing someone motivated by my writing. Just makes me.
Now, D20, let me pause the immersion for a second. D20, we're reading a weeb game together if you want to join us. I know it sounds like the straightest. Out. Okay. Maybe next time. It's a new experience, trust me.
Really happy.
Are you saying you never shared your writing before? Yuri nods. Really? I don't believe it.
I really only write for myself. And besides, people would just laugh at me.
Nonsense. Aww. Do you really think that?
No way.
Again, Yuri nods.
Don't worry, Steve. Not much reading left. I'll read the other girls. So.
Wait.
I'm looking forward to reading. Just joking. But...
Even your close friends?
What close friends? Says Yuri.
Yuri doesn't respond to that. Aww. I wonder why. Anyway. You want to share the poem you wrote today?
Yeah.
Get it?
I do. If it's with you.
Yes.
Okay. Holy fuck, why do I have to write so much?
Oh my god, yawn. Yawn.
The raccoon. It happened in the dead of night while I was slicing bread for a guilty snack. My attention was caught... Yeah, right? I don't know. My attention was caught by the scuttering of a raccoon outside my window. That was, I believe, the first time.
How are you reading this shit? That's the worst fucking font ever, dude.
This is the cursive I was taught or whatever. But insane. Some of the, yeah. The first time I noticed my strange tendencies as an unordinary human, I gave the raccoon, that kind of looks like success, you know, that's what it sounds like.
No, suck. Okay.
A piece of bread, my subconscious well aware of the consequences, well aware that a raccoon that is fed will always come back for more. The enticing beauty of my cutting knife was symptom. Was the symptom. The bread, my hungry curiosity, the raccoon.
An urge.
And she said people were gonna laugh at her work.
Tag me inside. All right. The moon increments its phase and reflects that much more light off of my cutting knife. The very same light that glistens in the eyes of my raccoon friend. I slice the bread, fresh and soft. The raccoon becomes excited. And perhaps I'm merely projecting my emotions onto the newly satisfied animal. The raccoon has taken to following me. You could say we've gotten quite used to each other. The raccoon becomes hungry more and more frequently, so my bread's always handy. Every time I brandish my cutting knife, the raccoon shows me its excitement. A rush of blood. Classic Pavlovian conditioning. Okay. I slice the bread, and I feed myself again.
Can we not date Yuri? Look at how much shit this is to read.
Bruh, that was beautiful.
She needs to calm down. That was amazing.
Shut your mouth.
It was a little more daring with this one than yesterday's. I was a little more daring.
I can see that. It's a lot more metaphorical.
He did not see any metaphors. Yes.
I don't know if it's my fault, but I can't begin to imagine what this poem is about.
That's right. It's a bit closer to my preferred writing style.
There's different writing styles?
Using the poem as a canvas to express my vivid imagery and conveying emotions through this.
Why would
people write shit?
Bruh!
If you want to do visual shit or vivid emotions,
ever heard
make
of
a fucking movie?
Ever...
Yeah.
It's beautiful, you uneducated fucks. Yuri, you're alright.
Not once did I give a shit enough to picture a raccoon.
Yeah,
normies.
If I take it at face value, then I can't even figure out what it's supposed to mean.
Well, I think it's something that different people can relate to in their own way. I wanted to express the way it feels for me to indulge in more than unusual hobbies, like fucking a squirrel or a raccoon. It's those sort of things I'm usually forced to myself. Huh. So I sometimes enjoy writing about them.
Why do you keep them to yourself?
Because
what if my cocksong was that much of a douche?
They're embarrassing.
His name is Mike Oxlog.
And people would make fun of me like you guys did when you just read it. You just laughing the whole time. Don't you have anything like that?
Look,
Mike Oxlog?
Well, yeah, I guess I do.
I feel everyone has a little something like that. D20 just left us. The best we can do is respect each other and our individualities.
Respecting women's.
Even if it's difficult sometimes, and some things make us uncomfortable. After all, if I hadn't learned to embrace my own weirdness, I would probably hate myself and have jumped. I might be ranting a little bit now. But I'm glad that you're a good listener.
We are all great listeners.
Great.
Oh, yeah.
I'm glad you're a good listener. That's a weird way to start a conversation.
I was staring at all three of your mouths. You're good at a lot of things.
Oh.
Writing, listening, putting that hot chocolate in my warm mouth. There really aren't many people like you, Mike Coxlong.
Welcome back, D20.
That's exaggerating a little bit.
It's just how I feel. I never thought I would feel so comfortable sharing my writing.
Hey, Sharon.
But now, I almost feel like I look forward to it. Hey, Sharon! Come look, Biggie Smalls just appeared in the bathroom. Oh, it's just a really nice feeling. And you're to thank for that. Now come over here and let me put my mouth around your joy stick.
It's nothing, really.
No, I'll put my mouth on it.
No,
Yuri smiles sincerely at me.
With my mouth in her mouth.
For wait, just a moment, wait a second. Her timidness seems to disappear.
Her tits seem to disappear.
I was no longer interested.
Alright, let's do Monica.
Oh my God, we gotta talk to other people?
Yeah, don't worry.
Fuck this!
Hi again, Mike Oxlong. Sorry, you were trying to bone. That was a right and going, by the way.
Alright, I guess.
I'll take that.
Hey!
As long as it's not going bad, I'm happy that you're applying yourself. Maybe soon you'll come up with a masterpiece. Especially now when you cock block. You never know, though. You know, you want to share what you wrote for today?
No. Oh, here you go. I give my poem to Monica.
All right. This one's good. It feels like you're not getting, you're not only getting more comfortable with your writing style, but the imagery is better than the last one I read. Just wondering, but have you been finding inspiration in Yuri's writing style? Ooh.
I guess so. You can't deny that she's talented.
Waifu material. Yeah, totally. I think her poems are the most romantic.
Agreed.
That's the best way to describe it. She's like a totally different person when she picks up a pen.
I noticed that too.
How'd she get her hair to go to that one side?
It's kind of... This is like a Pokemon. Like
anime! Or when she's talking about lit.
Or like a bow that's as big as her head.
It's like a light turns on inside her. I want to turn her on.
Sadly, it's hard to get much personal conversation out of her. Trust me, I've tried.
Not hard for me.
Who knows what's going on in that head of hers? Speaking of head, Monica.
I hope you don't mean that in a bad way.
No, of course not. I just meant that I wish she didn't keep so much to herself. But still, defending her like that. You must be pretty into her.
Yeah.
Lamau.
You completely misunderstood. Come on, Mike.
What if people in real life said, Lamau? Calm down, I'm kidding. Besides, I'm pretty sure she's already got a boyfriend. Fuck!
No! But Yuri has a boyfriend?
Yeah.
Wait, really? No.
Why'd she let me put that schlong in her mouth?
Yeah, fictional one anyway. She's like you, Shadow. She's
like you. That counts all the same. We don't have a chance. Monica kind of whispers that last part to me.
It's just a hunch, but...
Well... There's not really anything wrong with that.
Except everything. Like, whoa. You go.
Shut the fuck up.
Well, I know. I was just saying, Nipa. Anyway, you want to read my poem now?
No.
I like the way this turned out, so I hope you do too.
Alright, let's take a look.
Oh my God, there's not even anything to it.
No fucking rhyming. What the fuck?
It's better
but
if it doesn't
rhyme. It doesn't need to rhyme. Well, yeah, but it's way funnier if it rhymes.
Save me.
And you can't spit bars if they don't rhyme. Go ahead, Jenna.
Why am I doing it?
All right, the colors, they won't stop. Bright, beautiful colors. Flashing, expanding, piercing. Red, green, blue. An endless...
Cacophony.
Cacophony of meaningless noise. That noise, it won't stop. Violent, grating waveforms, squeaking, screeching, piercing, sine, cosine, tangent, like playing a chalkboard on a turntable. Like playing a vinyl on a pizza crust.
If someone does that, they're fucking stupid.
An endless poem of meaningless. And a bunch of love load me. Well, wait, hold on, Monica. Did you mean to read that?
Wait, scroll up. Like playing a chalkboard on a turntable, like playing a vinyl on a pizza crust. All right, so... That would make sense if like they're switching the two. So like playing a vinyl on a turntable. All right, I got you. Like playing a chalkboard on a pizza crust. Bitch.
Monica's poems suck, and they don't even.
Load me.
Yes.
I feel like I loathe her instead after that.
Hmm.
Whatever you say, Monica, here you go.
Even more abstract than your last one, huh?
Nipa! I guess it's just the way I write. I'm sorry if you don't like it.
Should be. Oh. No, I never said that. It's just a kind of thing I've never really seen before, I guess.
I just wanted to see without the
skirt things. Blowing up. I feel like we could pop a view if we just lefted it a little bit there.
Yeah, I'm looking to the left.
Oh, I dropped my pencil.
Oh, shit, my pencil. I kind of like playing with my space on the paper. Choosing where and how to space your words can totally change the mood of a poem.
Oh,
It's almost like magic. The way I wrote the lines short make it feel like they're trying to speak over the noise.
I see. Still hard for me to tell what it's about, though.
Is there a timeline in the game where you can fuck all the girls?
Or I don't think so. I think you have to choose.
There should be like an orgy ending.
I hope so. We'll see, I guess, if we make it that far. We'll probably dive in this game. Sometimes asking what a poem is about isn't the right question. Sorry.
I actually did a solo playthrough of this game and died right before I met with Yuri. I was really disappointed.
But then someone restarted the game, so I came back to life until they finished. Yeah. A poem can be as abstract as a physical expression of a feeling. Or a conversation with the reader. So putting it in that way, not every poem is about something. Anyway, here's Monica's writing tip of the day. Sometimes you'll find yourself facing a difficult decision. When that happens, don't forget to save your game. Uh-oh. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. All right. Return. You never know when you might change your mind. Holy fuck. Or when something unexpected may happen. Wait, is this tip even about writing? She's breaking the 17th wall. What am I even talking about? Nipa. That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening.
Thanks, Monica.
Alright, I'm pretty sure Sayori's rhyme, so fucking let's go.
Dude,
What's up, girl?
Fuck Sayori.
I like this one, Mike Oxlong, by the way. It has some nice feelings in it, Nipa.
Ah, I'm glad. Stop saying Nipa every single time there's a tilde. Does that mean it's better than yesterday's?
Let me think. I don't know. I guess I like them both. Nipa.
Not very helpful, you know.
Well, I'm not very good at figuring out if poems are good or bad. But that's why I just go by my heart. Nipa, if it makes me feel things, then it must be a good poem.
I'm not sure that's exactly how it works. No, that pretty much is exactly how it works. Then again, I guess conveying feelings is a pretty important part of this whole thing. Yeah, maybe. Honestly, I don't even know what kind of writing you like in the first place.
Yeah, me neither.
Face plam. Why don't you at least try giving it some thought?
You wanna write something for me? That's so sweet, Nipa!
Yeah, right. You're always thinking about other people.
Oh, cheater, cheater, pumpkin eater.
You need to think about yourself once in a while.
Oh, masturbation.
If you don't, you might end up getting hurt at some point.
Yep, the bigger you go,
you gotta loosen it up.
First. Well, I don't really know what you mean, but I'll try to keep it in mind.
Well, whatever.
Anyway, let's see.
I love how we treat this girl like trash.
I guess I like happy poems. Not we, just you. I guess my cock's long. Wait, sometimes I like sad poems, too. Sometimes a little bit of both.
They should change your name to Desiree with two eyes really far apart.
Yeah, holy fuck. You can. Wow. Where's the nose, even? What's the word I'm looking for? Bittersweet. Yeah. I like things that are happy and things that are sad.
Happy and sad? Can't see you liking something sad, Sayori.
Well, I like happy the most, but sometimes when you have a little rain cloud in your head, a sad poem can give the rain cloud a little hug and make a nice happy rainbow.
My God.
That's pretty sweet, dude. Good job, Sayori.
What did you do, my friend?
That's unexpectedly poetic.
We're playing a Wii game together. We're almost finished.
I can tell.
We're playing a Wii game. Would you be interested?
No, pass. Right. Hard pass.
It's gonna be a no for me, dog.
It is? Maybe I'm getting better at expressing my feelings after all. Thanks, Mike Oxlong. I should go write that down then. You can read my poem now, okay? Or we can read it in the next episode. Thank you all very much for watching.
Oh, shit.
I hope you guys enjoyed. Oh,
cliffhanger.
We'll see you guys in the next episode. Little fellas. Nipa.
It is sweet. Like when your girlfriend tells you you have the biggest dick out of all your brothers.
You have a big Nipas. Normies, don't scroll up. It's safe down here.